民主党政権の時に国際基準よりももっと厳しい、基準を設けてしまいました。そこまで、やる必要があるのかと、国際基準よりもさらに10分の1ぐらい低い基準をものによってはですね設定しておりまして、それから汚染水の話はですね、世界の英知を集めてやっておりますが、今その土壌土をですね凍土にしてしまう、凍らせてしまうという、今技術世界で初めてでありますけれども、
That as far as the food stuff here is concerned, there is no concern because under the previous DPJ government, depending on the commodity, they came up with even severe standard than the internationally accepted standard. So we must wonder whether that kind of setting up of a standard was really needed or not, because in some of the cases, the additional standard set by Japan then was 1/10 of an international limit which was accepted elsewhere, which could have been some obstacle standing in the way of the reconstruction of Fukushima, if I may say so. And also for fish stock and so forth, as far as the radioactivity related limit is concerned, very severe limit has been introduced into Japan as opposed to the international standard. So if we are really looking for safe food stuff, we should come from Fukushima, if I may even say so. It has become a culture, so to speak. And you also raised the issue about the contaminated water. And we are really tackling with this issue by collecting all the wisdom from all over the world. And for the very first time in the world, Japan is trying to sort of introduce permafrost, the process to freeze the soil so that no more groundwater which is contaminated can flow in to the vicinity of the nuclear power plant site and so forth. That is the one method which is going to be tried. And making the surrounding soil to become permafrost, it can be a bar which could shut down the further inflow of the contaminated groundwater into the area, so that further contamination of the two natural groundwater will not take place.
Ici, c'est la vérification pour la radiation. C'est avant d'entrer dans la centrale, on a besoin de faire ce test pour savoir quel est le niveau de radiation qu'on peut avoir. Donc, vous voyez, c'est mon whole body counter, hein, c'est marqué ici. Et puis, on va passer ensuite sur ces machines qui nous vérifient donc, en fait, le niveau de radiation que l'on contient dans le corps. Whole body counter. Donc, ça, c'est la première vérification avant de partir sur le site de la centrale d'Aichi.